Okay, we're back. This is the fourth video. We're doing a little bit over an hour today because we have more in mind, you know. Forgive me, my pants are kind of saying, yeah, I gotta fix my belt. But, you know, got some more things to talk about. So, Jeremy's gotta head out to the store. He got some groceries to go run and do. Got a ride coming for that. You don't have a car right now. But we got time to do another video. So we were just talking about, that we are, said before, we're down with anybody. We forgive anybody. We don't judge anybody, no matter what they do. We were just talking about someone who had killed somebody, you know, that, his people are coming through from the spirit world wanting to talk to him. Yeah. A young boy here, and we get the impression he's going to be doing some time. Probably. He'll be gone 20, 30 years, maybe more.
Yeah.
And when you're gone that long, you don't have any friends. You lose all your friends pretty much in the street. People forget about you, and you know, and then he has to live with what happens. And Jeremy and I are the type that we forgive anything, you know, even if it happened in our own family. If somebody killed my family or something, I'd be forgiven and understanding. I mean, I've got to say that in all honesty. If somebody went and killed my mom or something today, you know, for example, or someone like that, you know, I would have to live my spiritual teachings, and I would.
Yeah.
You know, like, I'd probably be chatting with her from the other side. I know I'd be.
Yeah.
You know, I wouldn't be upset because I know she wouldn't be dead. And to the best of my ability, I'd be forgiven.
Yeah.
You know?
It's very important to be forgiving.
No matter what.
Forgiving yourself and forgiving other people, no matter what they do, you know. Like I said, you know, some things can seem harsher and more hard to deal with.
Like, what if somebody killed your child?
Yeah.
You know, what if someone killed their five-year-old child?
Yeah.
What if your boyfriend shook the baby to death and killed him?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, could you forgive him?
Yeah, probably.
Think about that.
It'd be hard, you know, it'd be very hard. I'm like, even for me, that would be hard. The thing is that, you know, but the thing is, to move on and get the ball rolling in that healing process, you know, you gotta, like, let that person go.
That's
you know,
right.
You gotta let that person move on in their spiritual development, even though, you know, they may have harmed you in some way, shape, or form, or, you know. We don't condone it, you know, like I said.
We're not condoning that behavior,
no, but at the same time,
I'm not judging the judge either.
You gotta get the ball rolling on the healing process for yourself, and one thing to do is probably forgive.
Forgive.
Yeah.
Forgiveness is the biggest part. Forgive yourself, forgive others, always forgive.
Yeah, try to do that.
Forgiveness is the key to eternity.
Spirit.
Not my words, that's Christ's words.
Yeah.
Christ came through. Lord Christ came here to talk to us a few months ago. We had a long conversation, and he's jumped in to say that a few times during channeling sessions.
Yeah.
That's his word. Forgiveness is a big, major key to eternity. Not
yeah,
the only one, but a big one.
Even if you, like, wanted to think from a therapeutic sense, you know, like even psychologists and psychiatrists and stuff would probably say the same thing, you know, try to forgive, you know. That's the first step, you know. I mean, it's not necessarily our idea, you know, to forgive, but the thing is, to forgive is the idea. You know, you have to step above, you know, your anger and your possible griefs and things like that and forgive.
Yeah, I've got an example I can give on this too that has to do with spirits and other things, but it's about forgiveness. It just, it's kind of popped in my mind, psychically, it's coming to mind. You remember, like, you might have seen this back on the news back in May. But there was this thing in Chesterfield that happened on Reams Road. I used to hang out with a guy who lived on Reams named Chef. But anyway, like this boyfriend or a husband that went crazy, you know, and then his girl, the ex-girlfriend and the kids were living there. So the kids were getting off the bus. He drove to the girl's house and killed her, shot her in the head a couple of times. And then the police came, cornered him, and he blew his head off himself.
Yeah.
Now, immediately after that happened, like, we had both spirits. We could see them all.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that very same night, you know, I was seeing, like, the girl coming through. Now, within hours of her death, I was already seeing that young lady in the spirit world.
The guy was tripping.
Now, the guy was tripping. He didn't die until the next day.
Yeah.
In the hospital. The guy was tripping. He was in the self-imposed exile dimension by his own choice. No one put him there but himself. He was scared. He was tripping, thinking that, oh, no, I killed my... What did I do? And I killed her and me in front of the kids. The kids saw it all.
Yeah.
You know, their children. And he's like, now I'm going to hell. I can't go through there because then I'm going to hell. I'm just going to... He's like, I'm just going to have to stand out here the whole time and stay in here and just be by myself.
Right.
Because I don't want to be thrown in hell. That's what I was getting from the guy. So, anyway, you know, I took him through the portal. You know, I'll do anybody, no matter what they do. I just popped myself on in his dimension with him, as we described before. Another Matt came out of me and went in there, and so I was watching myself work like a movie in front of me, clear as day.
Yeah.
And were you there that day? No, it was just me that time.
I wasn't there.
I was laying in bed and doing it.
You told me about it, you know.
I was getting ready to go to bed. I was meditating before I went to bed, and then the news was on, and said, well, tonight this guy died, and I died. When I heard that, I was like, well, I better check where he is.
Yeah.
Something told me he was in that self-imposed exile dimension, and he sure was. Tripping, walking back and forth, crying, all this stuff. So I just popped myself in and chatted with him. And I'm like, look, you know, you're one of the lucky ones, brother. I'm not going to let you linger here for decades and centuries like some of these guys do, you know. I was like, if you want to go through, your girl is waiting for you. She's forgiven you already. Y'all need to be together to take care of the kids on the other side. And then he was crying and all this stuff, and I just took him through. You know,
yeah.
I popped the portal open to the higher spiritual dimension up in my mind. Purple light coming out of it. I said, look, you're not going to go to hell. Yeah, I can be punished, don't worry.
Exactly.
And the monks were there to meet him. The monks, Buddhist monks, spirit Buddhist monks we work with. Christ was there. I told him, look, Christ is going to be there to forgive you. Lord Buddha was there. All of them came through. And Christ, he consulted with Lord Christ about forgiveness. And then his wife came. The girl was there to greet him, you know. And then now I can see them together.